Welcome, Stargazers. Thanks for joining us. I'm Bob Bonadurer, Director of the Planetarium here at the Milwaukee Public Museum. Today, we're going to explore our current sky by mixing in some Egyptian astronomy. We have the sky set up for mid-May here before sunset at 7 o'clock. Now, let's work the magic of the planetarium and show you the planets and stars while the sun is still up. Two planets to look for currently in the sky are Venus and Mercury. We'll see how these planets will change quickly later on. Like many cultures, Egyptians saw the sky as gods. The entire sky was Nut here, holding up the heavens. Below that is Shu, the god of air, and Jeb, below that, is the god representing earth. Egyptians had many gods adorning their temples: Seth, Osiris, Isis, Horus, Ra. These religious associations could change too. Orion the Hunter is sometimes matched with Osiris and the bright star Sirius with Isis, wife and consort of Osiris. When Sirius reappeared in the morning sky just before dawn, they knew the Nile River would flood. That was crucial for their survival. This led the Egyptians giving us the first solar or yearly calendar. Okay, we're jumping back to the current sky. It's about 8:50, just after sunset. We're gonna watch how Mercury and Venus switch their positions. You'll see Venus getting lower each night. We're going about one night every 2 seconds. There it is on May 20th. May 21st, they're gonna be real close. That's a Thursday night. And then as we keep going, May 22nd, 23rd, 24th, you'll see the moon come into view on the 24th, and we'll stop it right here on the 25th, about 9 o'clock, 50 minutes past sunset. So Mercury, a little higher in the sky, Venus a lot lower. We're going to lose Venus altogether very soon. Now, let's move the sky a little darker, get away from the street lights, go to about 10 o'clock here, and notice you can see a few more stars because getting away from the street lights. So let's look at the Big Dipper up there. And we're gonna see it turn into a bear. So people see different things, right? The Dipper comes from the African Americans, called it a drinking gourd. The bear came from the Greeks. So what did the Egyptians see? Well, check this out. They saw a bull, followed by a floating man, then a hippopotamus that has a crocodile on its back. No one knows exactly why this procession was created. Today, we can still use the Big Dipper, of course, to find the North Star, or Polaris, the star that never moves, because it's an extension of the Earth's axis, or the pole, that we spin upon. People often wonder about the alignments of the pyramids and the stars, and they literally were a stairway to heaven. We're going to zoom in here on the Giza pyramid. This tunnel that you're going to see get bigger faces north. It is a pathway from the dead pharaoh to the northern sky, so he can rise up to heaven and join the imperishable ones, all the other pharaoh gods who circle the north celestial pole or north star. These imperishable ones never rise in the east, nor do they set in the west. All right, everyone, we are back in Wisconsin. It's 10 o'clock. And we are going to spin the Earth a little bit faster here and take you through our very short night. And notice the Dipper still leading you to Polaris, or the North Star. We'll slow the Earth down. It's 4:30. You got to get up early. But if you do, check out the planets. You got Jupiter and Saturn in the south, Jupiter being much brighter, and then Mars over to the southeast. So that's our little show today. Thanks for joining us for the current sky mixed in with a little Egyptian astronomy. Get out there, ponder some cosmic distances as you keep a safe distance.